Hi guys, and welcome to the season 3 finale epilogue of the raid season. And hopefully you guys had a real good experience and time watching the season 3. It was conveniently the exact same amount of episodes as the hardcore season that just was playing alongside it, which actually worked out. They finished pretty much at the exact same time. That wasn't deliberate, it's just how it happened. But in this little video I want to put together, I want to talk about stuff like the format, how we did it, and things about that I want to touch on. Stats in the playthrough, we'll talk about what happened throughout the season, and then also some things that we tried out with editing and some improvements that we want to do going on to the next season. So without further ado, the last time, let's crack straight into it. For season 3, it was actually very similar in length to season 2. 102 episodes in season 2, and then there was 92 in season 3. So it was 10 episodes shorter, but that is mostly due to one thing. In season 1 and 2, I actually made it that any episode after it hit about the 40-minute mark, no matter what happened from that point onwards, if I was in a raid, if I died, that would be the end of the episode. In this season, I didn't finish a single one of my recordings until I hit the 1 hour mark. So the main reason why the actual the whole season was slightly shorter was the fact that I made sure all my recordings hit 1 hour, even though the episode might only been 45 minutes because of we cut out the loading times and stuff. We actually had a very slightly shorter season purely for the fact that I made sure the recordings were slightly longer. I wanted to make sure every episode had as much stuff in there as it could, and you actually got a really good experience from watching a full length, let's go television type episode being around the 45 to 1 hour mark. Now we did have some longer episodes, but that's just how it is and how it plays out sometimes. But it was I feel like it was fairly consistent. You'd get an episode around the 45 minute mark to the 1 hour mark, which was really nice. Whereas in season 1 and 2, every now and then you'd have this episode, it would be super short, and I just didn't like it. Next up, we also experimented with the type of episode. So we did weeks where it was just looting, weeks of PvP, and weeks with tasks. Now, early on in the actual season, this worked out really well. I could put 5 episodes in to just purely making as much money as possible, upgrading the hideout, and you guys could actually see me experiment some new loot runs, and it worked out quite well. In the progression of the actual game, I think it was actually a good success. We got a lot done and made a lot of money, was able to progress the hideout really quickly. So then the actual playthrough went really smooth. The negatives to that is the actual filming of a PvP episode with the analytics, that sometimes took me up to 2 hours. 2 fights there, were definitely worth talking about both of them. So now's the time, let's go. Let's crack straight into it. All right guys, so we're back in customs and we are heading up to the dorms. So as I like to get into the dorms, I usually do shut that door behind me. So now we are back over to the new gas station, and we knew there was... Because say the recording went for about 1 hour and 20 minutes, then I had to start the new recording, watch back through the actual the combats of the actual episode. That could go for up to 30 minutes. And I would spend up to 2 hours just on the recording part of the actual episode. And that's not including all the other stuff. Like I write my notes to the editors, and all that. So it got very time consuming filming those PvP episodes. On your side, you probably saw, it was pretty much the exact same length episode. So it was a lot more time involved. And I do think that's a really good thing to give a more analytical side to the PvP. I really want to keep improving this though. I'm not sure if doing it in that manner is the best way. I kind of like the idea that the episode gets made like normal, and I watch the episode back at the end after it's been made, and then I give extra PvP notes that I can have pop up afterwards or something like that after the actual edit's done and like that. I'm not really sure. It's something I definitely want to improve on, but I think the feedback from the PvP episodes was really good, and I'm glad you guys enjoyed them. However, I want to condense the amount of workload in trying to film those episodes because it can get quite time consuming. Just to give perspective, there's a lot of actual, it's more, not just I press record, there's a lot of extra stuff that goes on with filming these episodes. So leave it at that. The task episodes is pretty much just me playing the game normally, just trying to be as efficient as possible with getting those tasks done. And that's where we'd get the large boosters in XP, because getting tasks done actually gives a lot of XP. I'm getting very good at getting my tasks done quickly and the order I do that. And I think you guys really enjoy the fact that you see how I get my tasks done and in the order and how I progress it. A lot of feedback I get is people that watch the show, they actually follow me and what I do each episode. So for example, if I get a quest done, they try and do the quest, even though it might take them an extra couple of raids to get it done. They find it's a way, it's kind of like a walkthrough where you actually can actually see how to get the task done without having to worry too much about, you know, like you'll see my pathing or my thought process as I explain it, which is really cool. The amount of people that have commented about how this is their first wipe, or this is the first time they've ever been able to get the Kappa, and it's been largely helped due to the raid series. So I love to hear that feedback. Now with the season layout, obviously the we had that format of looting, PvP and tasks early on, and then we just kind of dropped it as it got later on because we're either just entirely in PvP mode or just trying to get tasks done. There was obviously an issue towards the end where we had to try and get the nighttime kills, and it just wasn't happening on Nighttime Factory. And that's just due to the fact of where I live. I've moved back from Europe to Australia, and I think we're filming in about month four of the wipe to get at the end of this. And because of that, nighttime, even during peak hours, nighttime raids sometimes are very quiet. It's just how it is, unfortunately. But I guess it's a good thing to represent. You know, some places of the world don't have like the most populated servers at times. Whereas I would go in Europe, it doesn't matter really what time of the day, there'll be people in Nighttime Factory. And it has more to do with the fact that there's the possibility of people having more servers to select from. So there'll be at least one that will have people in there. Yeah, unfortunately, that kind of, I feel like it took away from the season. But I don't know, maybe you guys didn't mind it as much. But to me, I hated it. Every time I load into a factory raid, I don't know if you can see it on my face, but I was just like, I hate this. I really don't like it. And that's where I said, stuff it. I'll go labs and I'll go nighttime customs and I'll just run it every gunshot in hope to get it done. There is a fix and a workaround to that is I try and film as much of the season at the very start, but I'm not really sure if I want to do that. I also want to kind of keep the season only a few weeks ahead in filming, because if there's new patches, I don't want you to be watching episode, like, you know, 3 weeks after a patch comes out and there's a whole heap of new guns, or there might be a map expansion or something like that. Like, imagine if I was doing nighttime factory raids 3 weeks after factory expansion had happened and the map was totally different. I don't really like that. I think the 2 week filming advance is what I do, or I try to keep maintain. Gives a good example. If the patch happens, you're not waiting like ages to see the actual update in the content. So and it gives a proper representation of what Tarkov is at the time of watching. Now, this season, I didn't do it at all. And I didn't do it in last season, but the first season I did. In the first season, I had like a week intermission break just so I could like catch up, make sure everything's right and progress with it in a more smoother way. In the future season, I am actually considering putting a deliberate break maybe once or twice throughout the season. I do have the fear that obviously there'll be a drop off in viewership because of that. And that's just a reality of how it is. But the way I have these edited, as you noticed, was Frankie would do 1 week, Britt would do the next week, and they'd rotate. So they kind of did get their breaks between it. But I always want to keep increasing the quality of the edits. And sometimes it'd be nice to just have a week off and be like, all right, let's spend the week just improving the actual episodes mid-season. Because 4 months from start filming to end filming is actually like a long time of constantly putting episodes out without having a large amount of time to actually focus on improving it. So I try my best to always keeping the best quality value out for you guys that are watching it and investing your time into watching this. So I want it to be the best quality I can give you guys. So that's pretty much just my feedback on that. Now, what I want to do from here, we'll dive into the stats. I think this will be a really cool thing. So let's get across to my overall screen. Now, I'm going to compare this to actually season two's finale, so and epilogue, where it showed off my stats on there. So considering from season two to season three, season two was filmed nearly entirely in Europe when I was living in the Netherlands, and I think maybe the last 10 episodes were filmed in Australia, I think the last 10 episodes wouldn't have had to happen if it wasn't for a patch came out adding new streamer items and made it just take me like 5 extra episodes to farm them. But it doesn't matter. The amount of raids in the last season was 311, and in this season was 336. That can be contributed to a couple of things. The tasks did change from last wipe to this wipe. There was actually a lot of items that now had to be found in raid. For example, the 6B43 armor, it didn't have to be found in raid, but it was a lot more expensive this wipe because of it was. And just little things like that. So things change over wipes that make it a little bit harder to progress sometimes, and it will slow it down. I would like to know, but I don't really care too much, but we probably spent a lot of raids going into factory, to an empty factory and leaving. Whereas last season, that probably wasn't as much of an issue with the nighttime kill. Factory, you're always going to do a lot more raids of because they're shorter raids. And so if you're doing a lot more maps, say on customs and that, and you're progressing through the map that way, you're going to do a lot less raids in progressing through the season. Now, kill death ratio, survival rate, didn't really change too much. It was 6.5 kill death ratio in the last season to 6.3 in this. And there was a 58% survival rate compared to 51%. So anything over, I always say, is about 25 to 33%. Sorry about my eye right here. Anything over 25 to 33% survival rate is really good. All right. Don't feel like you need to have a 50% survival rate to be good at this game. You got to think of it as you're going into a raid, potentially up to 12 other players are in there. And you've got to go from one side of the map past those 12 players or 11 players and get to the other exit and survive. So everyone's doing their own thing, hunting players, getting their tasks done. And if you can get past all those people, one in four raids or one in three raids and survive, that's a really good job, right? Don't feel like you have to survive every second raid. One in three, one in four, one in five, all really good. Because you've got to start getting in the mindset that you're meant to survive every raid. You are meant to die a lot. And it's part of Escape from Tarkov is you try to survive and escape, but there are other people hunting you down. You know, like there's people on that setup task trying to hunt down any noise they hear with the shotgun. You know, there's people trying to get the Shooter Born in Heaven quest done, Punisher quest done, like nighttime kills. You're like, I'm just going in nighttime trying to get my nighttime kill. There's people out there trying to hunt people at nighttime. So don't be too critical of yourself. Don't reflect too hard on your survival rate as well. People that play in squads and that obviously going to have a higher survival rate compared to someone who plays solo. The one interesting fact that I thought was in the PMC kills department. So even though I did 35 extra raids, I killed 50 less PMCs to last season, exactly 50 less. And that could be contributed to the fact that my servers are slightly quieter, particularly later in the wipe. Early wipe, there's no real like big deal. The servers are completely filled, no matter what time of the day. But late wipe, they do definitely get quieter. And that is just a nature of the beast that it is. And so there was a lot of raids where I couldn't find PMCs. And unfortunately, I couldn't get the kills because there was no one to kill. So it could have been a lot different for all that. But when I was in the Netherlands, wasn't really too much of an issue. Very full raids all the time. And it wasn't too much of a big deal trying to get a kill because there was plenty of people to shoot at. Now, I don't really care too much about the next stat either. I don't really care too much about any of these stats, but I think it's interesting just to reflect on them a little bit. But stash value. So this season, I'm at 47 million stash value, which isn't a really great representation, but I'm just going to compare it anyway. And last season, we had 33 million in stash value. And the number one contributing factor to that was the Bitcoin farm. This season, you could just make bank just from the Bitcoin farm and you just make a heap of money. It wasn't a really big deal. You just logged in once a day, got 3 to 5 Bitcoins, depending on before or after the changes, sell them for 800,000 each. And, you know, you're making 2 million rubles a day and all you're doing is logging in. So obviously that's changed now, but in the last season, Bitcoins made you about 500,000 rubles a day. So a big difference right there. And you saw at some points in this season where I was just like, you know what? I'm just going to go slick because I can just buy 3 of them a day, you know? And that was just a flow and effect to the increase in the value of the Bitcoin where items didn't really have that much of an issue. I sold the thick item case, bought a heap of graphics cards, and those graphics cards are just pumping out Bitcoins now. And all I have to do is put in fuel every now and then. When it comes to stash value, that's probably the major factor there. I'm not going to go through my actual inventory stash. I tidied it up a little bit. I saw a few comments saying, Hobie cleans his stash in the next episode. No, I don't really care that much. All right, here for you, that one person, or whatever your name was, I'll call you Kevin. There you go, sorted. You know what? I'm such a nice motherfucker. Yeah, I'll even sort this one for you. There you go, look at that. Oh, it's all tidy. Perfect. For the value in the stash and all that, like You can look into the numbers as much as you like, but the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. As long as you've got enough money to keep doing what you're doing, after you've got kind of your Bitcoin farm going and you've got a bit of a money backup behind you, you pretty much run whatever gear you want, and you just make sure you keep looting smart, and you won't have any issues. I always do say, though, you can supplement, you know, every now and then with a scav run through Interchange, or just do a quick pistol backpack run and do a big, get a big load, like load of loot, and then sell it for like a million rubles. And then you don't have to worry about loot again for a little while if you are going into the losses a bit. So where to from here? So with the editing side of things, now we tried a few things out in the last few months, and you might have seen them in episodes. I know we definitely did some on the map guides and stuff, but we tried out, say, the money popping up on the screen during the loot runs. And there was a lot of really cool feedback about that stuff. I didn't like it completely, and that's why we didn't continue to do it. But I think just because the value of items changed so often, but I definitely like the idea of having a better way of explaining the value of items during that episode. And just the fact that we film 1 to 2 weeks in advance usually, I don't want like to say, oh, this item's worth 40K, and then literally the next day it's like 7,000, and it would just ruin it. So I don't know exactly how we're going to do that, but I would like it to make it so you can see value of items during that looting side. I tried out mini maps on the map guides and that. I did want to put them in the raid episode where I literally had a mini map up at the whole time, and we could zoom into it at any time to show you guys where I am on the map when I'm explaining stuff. Or I want to go over to Big Red now, like when I'm on customs, and I can have the map pop up and you can show you where Big Red is and the path that we're going to take, or we could take. There are ideas that I want to work on, and I'm always going to try and increase the production value for you guys. The issue is some of those things are very time involved, and time, they take up a lot of time. I'm going to keep working on trying to make this stuff happen. I know Frankie and Britt put a lot of time and effort into helping me, or they edited them, but we worked together to make these episodes the best that possible. But there's got to be a time limit to how long we can edit an episode for. So generally the time limit they had was between 4 and 6 hours, which is a lot to do in 4 to 6 hours. But I might even extend that a little bit more so we can include some of these extra cool things, because that would be great. I really want you guys to watch these episodes and be like, this is so sick. Like, I'm learning so much, or, you know what I mean? Like, I just want you guys to sit there and go, perfect. Like I said, we're going to keep expanding on these ideas moving forward, trying to make you guys have the most enjoyable viewing experience, a learning experience for the people wanting to learn from them, and we'll go from there. Now, the next season 4 of the raid season, there's going to be a couple of changes. The one thing I want to do is move away from it being a beginner guide and potentially move it into me being more myself and just going intermediate to advanced. Maybe having a few runs in between where I go, you know, just a little bit silly and just have some fun. But that's still part of my playthrough, showing you not just how to complete the game and progress through the game, but also just how I enjoy the game too. I think from a viewing experience, it will move a little bit more away from the walkthrough, playthrough experience where you guys get to see how I do it, and more into the how I enjoy doing the playthrough. Like, I enjoy leveling up and completing all the quests. I have a good laugh during it as well. But sometimes it's like, hey, let's just grab a 5.7 and just jump into labs and do a pistol, no backpack run. A pistol, zero to hero kind of run. And we can have fun doing that. And I'm still progressing through the game, doing my thing, but I'm showing you some of the things I do that makes it so enjoyable for me to play. I love this game so much. I love teaching you guys this game so much. It's actually the dream job for me. Little bit of disclaimer, I actually wanted to be a teacher when I was younger as well. I wanted to be a fireman or a teacher, and I've been a fireman, and I guess now I'm a teacher. So it's actually kind of cool that I was going to be a math teacher though. Like, my math is good, all right? Big brain math. I like the idea of me actually showing how I have fun playing this game whilst also progressing through to the Kappa. It might take a lot more episodes. It might even be faster. Who knows? But I think the next season needs to have a change. And that will be probably the big change that will happen. So it might be aimed more towards intermediate players or advanced tactics in how I do stuff, but you'll still see me progress through the game in a smart and methodical way that I usually do. All right, I think I've flapped my jaw enough for this episode, and I'm sure Frankie's put his little like speech bubble saying thank you and all the stuff he's done. And Frankie's editing this episode. It's not Britt. Britt is actually leaving us at the end of this month. And we'll have a new editor coming on, hopefully, in the next few weeks. So you'll get introduced to that person, whoever it is. And hopefully you guys will enjoy having them edit the episodes as well and being a part of the family, because it's really cool that I read the comments, you guys talking between the editors and that as well. I kind of wanted to feel like that homely, like, you know, we're all here having a bit of fun experience. And I even think it'd be cool to have a bit of a watch party sometimes. Just like, let's watch the episode together. I don't know how I'd do that, maybe on Discord or something. But, you know, I like to hear your feedback in real time too. That's why I generally premiere the first episode. The one thing I hate about premiering episodes on YouTube though, they butcher the quality. It's like, it says 1080p. We put them up at 1440p, but it looks like 720p. So I might premiere the next episode. I'll have to wait and see. But I'll make a decision on that. Anyway, guys, for the last time for season 3 of the Raid series, thanks so much for watching. If you haven't by now, like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. What are you doing? All right, 93 episodes in. Thanks so much for the support, guys. You actually are incredible. And you guys have honestly changed my life with all the success that we've had over the content creation. And if you've watched 93 episodes of my Raid series or all the seasons, thank you so much. It really is an incredible thing to be able to make content for you guys that you enjoy. So lastly, guys, I'll see you next time.